Hi friends, welcome to our channel Study Guide. This is chapter 2 of class 11th chemistry, that is the structure of atom. It is the part 2 of our video. Here we will be discussing the topics formulation of Bohr's model of atom, under which we will be studying dual nature of electromagnetic radiations, experimental results of atomic spectra, which these two are the main causes for the formulation of Bohr's model of atom. Second topic is postulates of Bohr's model of atom. Further, we will be discussing advantages and disadvantages of Bohr's model of atom. Starting with the first topic, which is formulation of Bohr's model of an atom. Under this, the two major contributors to the Bohr's model of atom we will be discussing here. First one is the dual nature of electromagnetic radiations. Now, what does it mean, dual nature of electromagnetic radiations? It means that the electromagnetic radiations possess both wave-like and particle-like properties. Though we are saying that electromagnetic waves which do not require any material medium for their propagation, but these electromagnetic waves or radiations possess both wave-like nature and particle-like properties. So, when the electromagnetic radiations possess wave-like properties, so as you studied the properties of wave in class 10th, same here, we will be studying the properties of waves. Since the electromagnetic radiations are of wave nature, so it also possesses the similar properties that are possessed by waves that you have already studied in class 10th. Here, first property is wavelength, that is distance from crest to crest or trough to trough, speed of light, rate of motion of crest or troughs, or you can also say it is the distance traveled by the wave per unit time. Simply you can also say this. Time period, time between passage of successive crest, or you can say it is the time taken by wave to complete one cycle. That is, time taken by wave to complete one cycle. Frequency is the number of cycles produced per unit time. Or you can say number of crest passage per unit time. Next property is amplitude. Distance from level of crest to the level of trough is known as amplitude. It is also mentioned in the figure by A. Also, there is one additional property also, which is known as wave number. Wave number is the number of cycle produced per unit length. Means in the definition of frequency we are using, it is the number of cycles per unit time. And in the definition of wave number we are using, it is the number of cycles produced per unit length. Mathematically, it is the reciprocal of wavelength. Means wave number mathematically is the reciprocal of wavelength. Means wave number is equals to 1 upon lambda. Lambda is a wavelength. Now, what are the limitations of wave nature of electromagnetic radiations? Here are some limitations. First one is the black body radiation. Now, what does the black body means? It is an ideal body which can emit absorb radiation of all the frequency. And the radiation emitted by such a body is called black body radiations. Now, it is considered that when any solid object is heated, it emits radiations over a wide range of wavelength. As temperature is raised, here it is misprinted, it is written as temperature is raised, it color changes from red hot to blue, but according to electromagnetic radiation, energy is directly proportional to intensity. So, on supplying heat energy, only intensity of red color should increase, but experimentally color changes. Now, what does it basically means? We will study this as ये माना जाता है कि जब भी हम किसी solid object को heat करते हैं, first it becomes red hot and ultimately it color changes to blue. But according to electromagnetic radiation, ये माना जाता है कि energy is directly proportional to intensity. Means, as we are raising the temperature,
only the intensity means the brightness of red color should increase, frequency should not increase, because the energy is independent of the frequency according to electromagnetic radiation. So no color change should be observed. But experimentally, we found that color changes. So this phenomena of black body radiation is not explained by the wave nature of electromagnetic radiation. Second similar effect is photoelectric effect. It is a phenomena of ejection of electrons from the metal surface when light of suitable frequency strikes on it. So it is a simple definition of this. Means when we are ejecting the electron on the surface of metal and the electrons are having suitable energy that can eject that electron, means they have threshold energy. So that phenomenon of electron is known as photoelectric effect. Now here is the formula which you will be using in your numericals, is energy of incident photon, that is E, is equals to threshold energy, that is E naught, plus kinetic energy of electron ejected. Now what does it? Threshold energy means, threshold energy is the minimum energy that is required to eject an electron, and the remaining energy is converted into the kinetic energy of the electron. Now it is also considered experimentally that the number of electrons ejected is directly proportional to the intensity of light, means more the brightness of the light incident, more electrons will be ejected from the metal surface. Second observation is maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectrons is proportional to the frequency of incident radiation and independent of its intensity. Means kinetic energy only depends on the frequency of incident radiation and not on the intensity. But these two phenomena are not explained by the wave nature of electromagnetic radiations. So here with us comes the particle nature of electromagnetic waves. Under this, we have Planck's quantum theory, which have its two main postulates, which are written below. First is, the radiant energy is emitted or absorbed discontinuously in the form of small packets called quanta. In case of light, these are also known as photons. Now understand this. Suppose a light in your room, and there, this is a hypothetical example which I am giving to you, so you will be able to understand this point. Suppose a man is sitting inside that light. Suppose कीजिए उसके अंदर एक man बैठा हुआ है and वहाँ से वो light की जगह small small packets फेंक रहा है, जिसकी वजह से आपके पूरे room में lightning हो रही है. That small packets of energy through which the whole room is light up are known as quanta, and in case of light these are also known as photons. So this is a basically hypothetical example which will help you to learn this point. Now the next is, the energy of each photon is directly proportional to frequency of radiation, that is E is equals to h nu. Here nu is the frequency of radiation and h is Planck's constant, means the energy of each photon that the light contains is directly proportional to the frequency of radiation. Now what is the value of Planck's constant? The Planck's constant value is 6.626 into 10 raised to power minus 34 joule per second. It is the value which you will be using in your numericals. Now here are some formulas which will definitely help you to solve your numericals. First one is E is equals to E naught plus kinetic energy, which I already told you in the photoelectric effect. You can also write it as H nu from the Planck's quantum theory, its postulate. H nu naught is the threshold frequency, means the minimum frequency to eject an electron. Kinetic energy is written as half mv square. Nu can also be written as C upon lambda. This relation you might have learned in class 10th. So here the relation becomes. All these relations will be helpful for you in solving your numericals. Moving on to our next topic, that is atomic spectra. It is when a radiation is passed through a spectroscope
The pattern obtained by splitting of radiations into its component is called spectrum. Means, here it is a device, spectroscope. It is misprinted. Instead of L, it is P. It is a device containing a narrow slit and a glass prism. So, when radiations are passed through this device, a pattern is obtained by splitting of those radiations. Means, these radiations are split into small parts and into its components, and this is called spectrum. This splitting of radiation into its component is called spectrum. Now, our next topic is continuous spectrum. Here, it is a types of atomic spectra. Two types of atomic spectra are there. First one is a continuous spectrum and second is a discontinuous spectrum. When we look at continuous spectrum, it is simply that when a white light is passed through a prism, a continuous band of seven different colors known as vibgyor is obtained. You can also see it in the figure. When the white light is passed through the prism, a continuous band of seven colors is obtained on a screen, which is also known as vibgyor. Second type of spectrum is discontinuous spectrum. Discontinuous spectrum is basically, it is a spectrum produced either by absorption or emission of electromagnetic radiations by matter. Means it is of two type again, absorption or emission spectrum. Continuous spectrum that I have discussed, here you can see in this figure, first figure is showing the continuous spectrum. Means no black line is there and it is continuous in nature. No break is there. First figure is the continuous spectrum. Second is the absorption and emission spectrum, which we will be discussing it later on under the heading discontinuous spectrum. Now under discontinuous spectrum, first one is the absorption spectrum. Now we will understand this. What is absorption spectrum? It is basically when electromagnetic radiations are passed through any solution of any substance and transmitted light is passed through a spectrometer, some radiations of particular wavelength are absorbed by substance and dark lines are observed in bright continuous spectrum. As you see in the second figure, it is the same. Means, consider a hypothetical example. Suppose you are passing a rays through a beaker and inside man is sitting, that is taking some part of the light that you are throwing and the remaining light is projected on the screen. So the toffees that man brings, there black lines appear making this figure second, which you will see on your screen. So basically absorption spectrum mein kya hota hai hamare paas, solution mein se pass ko karte hain electromagnetic radiations aur jo transmitted light hoti hai wo hum screen pe observe karte hain, usme se kuch particular wavelengths ki light absorb ho jati hain jiski wajah se black lines absorption spectrum pe observe hoti hain. Now emission spectrum is here. Emission spectrum, under this, it is a spectrum of radiations emitted by a substance is called an emission spectrum. The substance whose emission spectrum is to be studied should be excited to higher energy state by heating or by irradiating with radiations of suitable frequency or by passing electric discharge through it. Basically, when we are studying emission spectrum, we have to excite that substance whose emission spectrum we are going to study. When electron in excited substance come back to the ground state, they emit certain radiations of the discrete frequencies. This emitted light is analyzed by a spectroscope and a spectrum is observed which consists of a large number of lines on the dark background. Each lines correspond to different definite frequency of wavelength. It is just the opposite of absorption spectrum. In absorption spectrum, some light of wavelengths are simply absorbed, and here those lights are emitted when the electron is coming from the excited state to the ground state. Here two notes are given which you can study. These lines spectra are used for identification of different elements, as every element has different spectra. Similarly, as fingerprints of human are used for the identification, so for the identification of various elements, these line spectrum are used. The second point is, the dark lines in the absorption spectrum appears exactly at the same place where lines in emission spectrum appear. Thus, both type of spectra of a substance are complementary to each other. Suppose now if you are seeing this figure here, if you merge the figure 2 and figure 3rd, you will get the figure 1st. Means the last two figures are complementary to each other.
With this, coming on to our next topic, that is postulate of Bohr's model of atom. All these basics which we have studied led to the formation of Bohr's model of atom. Now, the important postulate of this theory are: electron revolve around the nucleus with definite velocity in concentric circles, circular orbits situated at definite distances from the nucleus. The energy of electron in a certain orbit remains constant as long as it remains in that orbit. It neither emits nor absorbs energy. These are termed stationary states or mean energy states. Means what does it basically means? Electrons are revolving, means electron nucleus ke around kuch concentric circular orbits. Concentric means having the same common center, same concentric circular orbits mein ghum rahe hain, unki energy bhi constant hai, aur jaise hi wo ek orbit mein jab tak ghumte rehte hain, na hi to wo absorb karte hain energy aur na hi emit karte hain. Means na hi lose of energy, na hi gain of energy. This also explains the stability of atom, because when they gain energy, they get to higher energy state, and when they lose energy, they get to low energy state. It means when they are revolving in a particular orbit, they neither gain nor lose energy. Second is, it is very important, it is also known as Bohr's quantization postulate, which states that the angular momentum of an electron is quantized. Bohr proposed that the angular momentum of an electron is quantized, thus the motion of electron is restricted to those orbits where its angular momentum is an integral multiple of h upon 2 pi. Quantized means integral multiple of something. For example, the integral angular momentum of electron is the integral multiple of h by 2 pi, where h is Planck's constant. Thus we have a relationship mvr, formula of angular momentum, is equal to n h by 2 pi, where m is the mass of electron, v is the velocity of electron of said orbit, r is the radius of that orbit, and n is simply an integer. It is also known as Bohr's quantization postulate. Fourth postulate is, the stationary states or allowed energy levels are only those where n is equals to 1, 2, 3. Means integer hota hai jisme n. This is called Bohr quantum condition. The energy of an electron changes only when it moves from one orbit to another. An electronic transition from an inner orbit to the outer orbit involves absorption of energy. Similarly, when an electron jumps from an outer orbit to the inner orbit, it releases energy, which is equal to difference between the two energy levels. The energy thus released in form of radiation of a certain frequency appears in the form of line in the atomic spectrum, which we have discussed earlier. If the energy of an electron in the outer orbit is N2 is E2, and the energy of electron in the inner orbit N1 is E1, then it is E2 minus E1 is equals to delta E, which by Planck's quantum theory equals to h nu. Moving to next postulate, it is, the value of n could be small integers 1, 2, 3, and these correspond to the first, second, third, and so on. Quantum states are shells for the electron and is termed as principal quantum number, which we will be discussing under the heading quantum mechanical model of atom. What is this principal quantum number? Now, next postulate, based on the Bohr theory, Bohr calculated the radius of various orbits and the energies associated with electrons present in those shells. What is the radius? Here, the radius is given by n square a naught upon z, where a naught is 52.9 picometer. Z is the atomic number. It is the formula to calculate the radius, n square a naught upon z. Also, it is observed that the energy of the fixed energy levels, those energy levels, is negative. What does the significance of that negative electron energy? The significance of that negative electron energy is, if you look at the formula is minus RH z square upon n square joule. Z is the
Atomic number, N is the number of energy level, and RH is the Rydberg constant. Its value is 2.18 into 10 raised to power minus 18 joule. Now, what is the significance of this negative sign in the energy? The negative sign means that the energy of the electron in the atom is lower than that of the energy of a free electron at rest, which is taken zero by convention because it is not under attraction from the nucleus. So when electron moves closer to the nucleus due to electrostatic attraction, the work is done by electron itself and energy is released. When something is doing work by itself, then in that case energy is released. Thus the energy of the electron becomes less than zero, that is negative. This is the significance of negative electron energy. Now, what are the advantages of Bohr's model of atom? It explains the stability. Second is explain atomic spectra of one electron species, those species which are having one electron. Disadvantages: unable to explain fine spectrum of hydrogen, unable to explain Zeeman effect. What does it mean, Zeeman effect? Zeeman effect means the splitting of spectral lines in the presence of magnetic field. Third is unable to explain Stark effect. Stark effect is splitting of spectral line in the presence of electrical field. Fourth is could not explain ability of atom to form molecules by chemical bonds. Since the Bohr's model says that atom is stable, then why does it form molecules? Because every species wants to be stable, then atom is stable. Why it is forming molecules? It is unable to explain this. Fine spectrum of hydrogen se mana matlab hai ki in the spectrum of hydrogen we observe doublets, that is two closely spaced fine lines, means there is a small distance between the two fine lines that is not explained by Bohr's model of atom.